Hey Reddit, what's the strangest coincidence you've ever personally experienced? My old work ran a secret Santa once the week before Christmas. It was a $10 limit and the person I was buying for I didn't know very well. I left my buying to the last minute because I just didn't know what to get her. So I was in town and walking past some shops when lo and behold, I see an old copy of Oliver Twist in the window of the secondhand bookstore. It just called to me. So I went in and picked it up. I checked the first page for the cost and guess what, $10. Perfect. So come the day of the Secret Santa, we were all opening our gifts, some 150 people. Out of the corner of my eye I see some people crowding around a woman who is crying. I keep listening and people are calling out for the person who was her Santa. I go over and reveal that it was me. The lady I had bought for was crying and hugged me. She said 10 years ago her house burned down along with all her odd possessions. The book that I bought her was her favorite and also the exact same edition, so had the exact same cover she remembered. Because it was a secondhand book, it was even weathered in the same places she remembered. So it was as if I grabbed the book off her shelf before the fire and delivered it to her 10 years later. This should somehow be blown up into a movie. Here in my little town in northwest England, there's a good kebab shop from which the lads and I have ordered for years. We've been in there after countless nights out and had them deliver to our doors. So we know the guys who work there pretty well. They are mostly Turkish. Once a few of us got together for a short break in Turkey, having got off the plane, we waited in the car park outside for another pal who'd been on a different flight. As we stood, soaking in the ambience of a new country, none other than the tall guy from our local kebab shop walked across the road right in front of us, 2,000 miles from home. That was weird. He was an undercover Turkish agent who was also good at kebabbing. Seeing Paul McCartney, the Beatles, on TV in 2001, and noticing he was tall. Next day I'm walking down a very quiet street, and walking towards me is a really tall guy, and it was Paul McCartney. He must have seen my expression, so he veered my way, stuck his hand out and said hi mate. I was shocked. 18 years later I'm still shocked lol. I'm 6 feet 1. Turns out he's 5 feet 11. Maybe he was just lanky. He certainly appeared tall to me. I should also add that he didn't just stick his hand out, I meant to say he shook my hand. Crazy. He then briskly walked away. A very brief encounter but a really important one for me. I also wouldn't blame anyone for not believing me. It's a weird story. I used to get two buses home from work. I got off the first one having left my phone and keys on the front seat of the bus without realizing. Got on the second bus, went to my favored front seat and my possessions that I didn't know were missing were waiting for me. The bus had changed driver and route. Still freaks my nut out to this day. Phone. Wallet. Keys. Nobody believes me when I tell this story, but one day my husband and I ran into the same couple at three different places, in two different states. So my husband and I had an errand to run out of state. We leave early and stop to get breakfast. The couple was sitting across from us. The lady had on a funky shirt, which is why she stuck out in my mind. After breakfast we drive the next state over to the office we have an appointment at. We're waiting in the lobby and the couple from the breakfast joint walks in. Weird, so we spend the day finishing up our errands and then we drive back home. I didn't feel like cooking so we stopped to get some dinner at the pub. We sit down at the table and guess who's already eating at the table behind us, the same friggin' couple. I was in St. Augustine on vacation. On the way there I just happened to think about this girl I knew back in college in Orlando. Just sorta wondered what she was up to and the like. Sure as crap I ran into her in a bar there the first night. She was there celebrating graduating from PA school. Me and a friend took some acid one night and were tripping hard. Decided to walk to a gas station and get some smokes or something. We walked by a car lot in the small town I'm from and all of the cars in the lot were cop cars. We were both walking ramrod straight all the way to the store. Very quietly bought whatever we went there for and took a back street back to his place. We just stared at each other for like an hour and didn't speak after we got there. Turns out the city had bought a whole new fleet of cop cars and they had all been delivered there and were on the lot for just that night. was sitting in a restaurant about 200 miles from where I live telling my mother, who was visiting from a different country, about a trip I had to another country, about 6,000 miles away, with a work colleague, and the lady at the table next to us leans over and says, "I think you're talking about my son." Turns out I was sitting next to my colleague's parents while showing my mum pictures of our trip. I was in Paris and some Americans were lost. They were the grandparents on my high school classmates from Nebraska. It's a small world. In grade 10 English class, the teacher didn't have anything planned for us to do and it was close to the end of the year, I guess. So she goes to the big cupo board in the corner and pulls out a stack of copies. It's examples of a successful essay written during a final exam, so we can learn what a good one looks like and how to build a narrative, etc. The topic of these was, what was the most pivotal moment of your life? There's three examples, ranging in proficiency. We read through the first two, and I volunteer to read the last one aloud. I start reading, and I stop. The essay was about me. My big sister had gotten a really good mark 6 years earlier on her final exam essay, which she wrote about the day I was born. I got pretty emotional about that one. Worked half day, drove 6 hours from Southern California to Northern California for car camping with my wife, chose obscure campground which was neatly deserted, off season, picked the most deserted and remote campsite location. We planned on rocking the tent, were bummed after setting camp and another couple selects site right next to us. Turns out to be a co-worker I'd spoken with earlier that day. I hadn't told co-worker anything about plans. We weren't close. Earlier that day we spoke briefly of work-related issue. How annoying. Something similar happened to me except I didn't know them. They could have pitched anywhere in a huge field but they chose right next to our tent. My wife and I were in Tucson visiting my mother who just moved there. My wife decided she wanted tamale. We drove around for 2 hours stopping in restaurants looking for tamales. Couldn't find one. Went back to my mother's apartment. Literally 2 minutes later somebody knocked on the door of my mother's apartment asking us if anyone wanted to buy any tamales. Next time you're in town, try Tucson Tamale Company. They're excellent. Have multiple locations and you can buy frozen packs of two each. 1 year I got a roommate through Craigslist. The guy was weird for sure, but good-natured and paid rent. Anyway, after about 2 months of living with him, my cousin comes over to hang. I introduce the two and my cousin in the most chill voice ever said, "Nah man, we know each other." Turns out they were college roommates 5 years earlier in another state. Oh my god, they were roommates. Not me, but a pretty interesting story in my family. Two of my great-grandfathers got imprisoned in the same jail and served time together. My great-grandfather on my mother's side was an architect and even drew my other great-grandfather's house. My sister, Emily, was on a ski lift in New Mexico when some younger girl across from her asked if her name was Emily. Apparently the stranger, who kind of looked similar but underage, had found her lost it the year prior and had been using it for a year to buy alcohol. After this blew up, I texted my sister, who reminds me it was weirder. She was later hiking with friends for 17 hours. They got tired, thumbed for a hitchhike and got picked up by this girl's twin. That's the best story right here. Imagine her going through emotions as she recognizes that the girl in front of her is who she has been pretending to be for a year. I moved from my small hometown, halfway across the country, to a small city where I knew absolutely no one. At the first party I went to in the new town, I started chatting with a guy. Turns out he had also just left my small hometown. I met a Canadian guy while on holiday in South America and we ended up going sightseeing together. At the end of the day, a person behind us tapped him on the shoulder and asked if the scar behind his ear was from cancer surgery. They got talking. Turns out they were from the same small town in Canada, had the same type of brain cancer and had been operated on by the same surgeon. Something's up with that town. Was at the dentist getting a crown extension. Dentist: "Hey, you were born on the 13th of July, so was I." Assistant: "Me too." We all shared a look of surprise and longing with each other, longing to be closer. Then they drilled the absolute frick out of my teeth. That's my birthday, too. Had a kidney transplant last year. Nurse makes a comment about it having my name on it. He elaborated to say that the donor has the same surname as me. Plot twist, donor was a parent sibling. An officer from a different PD was showing me a picture of a guy they wanted to arrest in a different part of town. As I looked up from the computer, I see dipshit riding by on a bike, literally 5 feet away from the squad car. I can imagine it's like a scene from a movie. Yep, we never could catch the bastard. Said bastard passes by slowly on bike. He sure was one elusive son of a bee. Said son of a bee waves at the cop. Cop waves back. Yeah, we've really just given up at this point. Who knows where he is? Could be halfway across the country by now. 2 years ago I was in Tokyo on holiday. I looked on Instagram and saw an old friend post a story showing he was also in Tokyo. We hadn't spoken in a few years, but I sent him a message letting him know we were in the same city. Not even 5 minutes later, we walked into a bar and he was standing there. This past November, I was in Toronto on business. After dinner, we went to a pub downtown. The first person I saw when I walked in was the same friend from Tokyo. We both live in Winnipeg. We've got to stop meeting this way. Was at a convention. There were only a few people in the room. My friend and I wanted an autograph from a voice actor. He started singing in his character voice. There were two random guys next to me. One pulled out a video camera to record it. Years later, my husband and I are talking with friends, and the convention comes up. The guy with the video camera was my husband. I also took a picture later that day of the crowds, and he is in that picture. I stood next to my husband years before I met him. This is one of the things I always wonder about. The people I know now, how many times did I bump into somehow in the past? If there is an afterlife, I hope I get access to such a database. I have an uncommon last name and a not too common first name. I was in the hospital for a surgery and the person in the next room was there for the same surgery. Come to find out that we were second cousins and never knew that the other existed. He had the same name as me and his wife had the same name as my wife. The pastor of church where I was musician informed me that a wedding couple would be coming to see me after Sunday services to discuss music for their forthcoming ceremony. It turned out to be a girl I dated in high school that I hadn't seen or heard from since graduation and her fiancé. She remembered my organ playing from back then and already knew what pieces she wanted. I didn't even have to demonstrate. Organ playing. I've had several small world experiences but the biggest was talking to a girl after my first university class and discovering through the course of a 2-hour-long conversation that our grandmothers had been each other's maid of honor and my aunt and her mom were best friends since childhood. Back in the early mid-90s the phone system changed and you no longer needed to dial the area code for a long distance in-state call. We're a small state with only one area code. One morning I woke up to the phone ringing and when I picked up I recognized the voice on the other end as belonging to my old boss from a few years ago. She had an unmistakable voice. We had a nice conversation for a bit before she realized she had dialed the wrong number. I lived in a different town in a different part of the state, but the number must have been off by only one digit from the one she'd tried to call. To add to the coincidence, I had overslept and would have been late for work if she hadn't called me and woken me up. Started dating this girl a few weeks ago. We get to talking about where we live, etc. She lives in not only the same building but exact same apartment I lived in 2 years ago. It was so freaking bizarre walking into my old apartment that I never thought I would see again. What are the odds? Oh man. My now husband and I had the same deal. We, roommate and I, were the tenants that moved into his apartment right after him. We even came to look at it while he was still living there but not home. I had no idea I was looking at the furniture of someone I'd eventually marry. The first we hung out he came over and told me. I couldn't believe it. The person who sits next to me at work copies everything I do except she has no way of knowing. I wear a blue sweater. She wears a blue sweater. I bring leftover spaghetti. She brings leftover spaghetti. It is so weird I almost hate her. When I was 18, I lived in a town a very long ways away from where I ended up moving. I struck up a friendship with this guy from work in that town. We play Halo, watch movies, act, and he was awesome. I ended up moving suddenly due to a family emergency, and never got his contact information. I didn't even remember his name a decade later, but I thought of him often as he was an awesome guy through all the years. 11 years later, I'm working at my job, carpooling with someone from my training class, and one night he asks if I mind his roommate being in the car as he was going to take the car after we got off at work and use it for the night. He introduces us. I turn around, and in the back seat is the guy from the town a very long ways away. We reconnected immediately, and now live together. He's my best friend, for sure, and the godfather to my children. When I was a kid, around 13, I played a lot of a video game called Diablo 2. I started a clan with a few people I'd met on the internet and we played every day. At some point we were helping some random person and he asked to join. We thought he was nice enough so we let him in. As part of this clan we had a shared account we used to store game items for each other. After about a month of playing this new guy goes in and changed the password, steals the account and defriends everyone. Completely disappears off the map with all of our stuff. Fast forward a year later and my family moves to Texas and it's my first day at school. I'm sitting in algebra class talking to the person in the seat next to me and he mentions he plays Diablo. I said me too and that I ran a clan and everything. I asked his username and it was him. 2,000 miles away from where I first virtually met this guy, he's sitting next to me in math class. When I told him mine, his face went into total shock and he didn't know how to respond. It was awkward for sure. Ended up telling him I didn't care and was over it, but let's just say we didn't end up becoming friends. Probably thought you had tracked him down to exact your revenge. When I was 1 year old, we moved to a city some 500 kilometers away from where I was born. 15 years later my father decided to put me in a boarding school in the area of that first city because he went there too. I got randomly put in a room with two other guys, which one of them is still my best friend Toddy. When I first visited that friend at his home, I discovered that he not only lives in the same city as we did, not much of a coincidence, as it's the only major city in that area, but in the same freaking house. OFC, I couldn't remember our old house. So I called my father to confirm that it's the same address and it turns out that he very briefly knew my friend's family from selling the house. I hate you, and Toddy says I am totally right with that. Toddy sounds like a great best friend. Last summer, I went to New York with my family for a week. A friend of mine that I hadn't seen since she graduated from college was living and working in New York at the time. So we decided to meet up for drinks. As we were walking through Times Square at 11 p.m. on a Saturday, who did we see on the other side of the street but another friend of ours from college. I knew he had been living in New Jersey, but he was in New York for a Grindr date. The three of us went to a bar and talked about life and how none of our friends live in Ireland anymore. They've all moved abroad. It was bittersweet and a crazy coincidence that three friends from a small university in Dublin would surreptitiously meet in New York City. This got a lot weirder when you mentioned you're from Ireland, P. Went to college, met a cute girl. Where do you go to high school, she asks. You've never heard of it, I reply. I grew up in a town of 1,200 people, graduated in a class of about 90. Try me, she says. And that was the beginning of finding out that not only had she heard of it, she had almost attended it because her family had lived in one of the neighboring towns very briefly when she was growing up. We shared dozens of mutual friends, and had apparently spent our young lives narrowly missing each other. Later, after we started dating, we learned that one of our mutual friends had been trying to set us up with each other for years. She was overwhelmed with laughter when she saw that we were finally together, completely without her involvement. I asked her to marry me. She said yes. We went out to dinner with our parents so they could finally meet. Her folks arrive at the restaurant and see mine. Her mom goes, "Oh hey, my dad's name. So this is your son." How they had been co-workers years ago, of course. We've been married for 11 years now. Got a good thing going. We intend to keep it. I'll be glad if you all enjoy this. I love talking about my wife and have tons of wholesome stories like this. We do well because we each feel like we're the lucky one. Enjoy your day. I was worried you were related. Had recently moved cities and had a new local phone number. Had to make a lot of calls to various utilities, etc, to get everything all set up. I call one of them. I'm speaking with the customer service rep. All is going fine until she asks for my phone number. When I tell her, she starts freaking out on me. Who are you? How did you find me? How do you know that phone number? Kind of stuff. eventually managed to get her calmed down to the point where we could figure out what was going on. Turned out she had been in an abusive relationship where her ex had stalked and harassed her, including him and his friends making threatening calls constantly. Eventually she had moved to a different part of the city and taken a new, enlisted phone number. My new phone number was her old one, and the moment I said it she assumed he had tracked her down once again and the harassment campaign was about to begin anew. I'm not sure she truly believed me when I explained it all, but we eventually got through the phone call. That must have been terrifying for her. If she really thought she was being stalked again, should have just acted like nothing was up and transferred the call to another person or her supervisor. I would hope they'd be understanding. But I guess she might not have been thinking straight from being so scared. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.